joyful good morning to everyone. This is the day the Lord has made. Despite the circumstance that has brought us together, we will rejoice and be glad in it. We come to our last moment in celebration for Griselda Hewitt-Pender. We thank God for her life and the years that we have been privileged to cross paths with her. I pray that God will give us the strength as we celebrate. To celebrate knowing that God does all things well. Let us begin. As we sing, I will enter in his gates with thanksgiving. That's the first hymn or song on the order of service. Let us sing to God's name.
Thank you.
Come listen. Schumpertor. Hearts. Eyes filled up with tears. Overwhelmed with sadness and in grief. The God who comes. We come this morning because you bid us come. You invite us, cast all in tears. Because you care. You invite us. In your word, in your life, bring all the burden, all the burden and the laden. I will come because you invite us, and those who mourn will find comfort. So God, this morning we pray, by your Spirit, you will give us comfort, especially in God, the family, the friends, the loved ones, all who find it difficult to make sense of this moment. Give them strength. Give them comfort. For your word reminds us that you are our refuge and our strength. So help us, oh God, in this moment to find ourselves in your presence. And only do we find refuge when your word tells us in your presence there is fullness of joy. Help us to find joy this morning. Lift us up to that place, oh God, where we see you afresh. Oh God, we pray that we find the strength and even the joy in going through this difficult experience this morning. We wait upon you because you're God and God alone. In Jesus' name I pray. Jesus, suitable him for our prayer of comfort. All our sins and grief to bear.
Jesus knows our every need. I greet you in the name of our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. I stand here filled with joy, but yet I shall miss my sister, and we all will. I'm going to tell you a little about her, but in most of it, I'm going to share it with you in Scripture. I want to share with you that she was a faithful servant of the Lord. She joined us in 1984, Community Baptist. I worked with her in the ministry. I met her at Johns Woodson Junior High School. And we were very happy. We sat down, we had a dialogue. She said to me, I'd like to minister. I would like to do the Lord's work. She came in and she now worked with the prison ministry also too. And she ministered in my absence and in my presence. She was a faithful soldier. She, when the church door was open, she was there. When there were members in the ministry that were sick, she was willing to go and pray with them. We had prayer meeting at a home. We had a good time. But I want to tell you that God used her while she was here on this earth. Say to the family, that was a faithful soldier, going on home to be with the Lord. But I'd like to bring something to your attention from Scripture. I will mention the passage in case you would like to read over it again. In St. John 1:13, which were born not of blood, nor of the will of the flesh, nor of the will of man, but of God. She was a godly person. The essential vision she had, Jesus answered and said unto him, Verily, verily, I say unto thee, except a man be born again, cannot see the kingdom of God. She brought her children to service and grandchildren as well. Felt that everybody should get the knowledge of knowing Christ. Yes, in 2 Corinthians 5:17 says, Therefore, if any man be in Christ, he is a new creature. All things are passed away. Behold, all things are become new. Yes, to believe in witnessing for the Lord. Titus 3:5 said, Not by works of righteousness which we have done, but according to his mercy, he saved us. Hallelujah. By the washing of regeneration and renewing of the Holy Ghost. New creature. She ministered the word. And by the word of God and 1 Peter 1:23 said, Being born again, not of corruptible seed, but of incorruptible, by the word of God, which liveth and abideth forever. Our sister gone home to be with the Lord. Yes, her mission is over. As the Bible says, in John, 1 John 5:12, He that hath the Son hath life. He that hath not the Son of God hath not life. So those of you who are not under the blood of Jesus, we encourage you to serve and surrender your life to Christ. Only way we can get into this hymn, into his heaven, is through his only begotten Son, Jesus Christ. God alone, as he came to this world, to save all mankind. May God bless you. And we bring condolences from my family as well as Community Baptist Church, Plot 7, Estate Pearl. May God bless us as we march together. Amen.
Pastor and Mrs. Williams, his kind words, trusted words, helped to comfort the family, knowing that Sister Pender served the Lord every opportunity she was given. She served God. At this time, we invite 2 minutes reflections, and family has asked me to encourage you to stick to 2 minutes. 2 minutes reflections. See no one. Let me, on behalf of my family, Bethel Amy Church family, extend to each of you our sincere condolences in the passing of Sister Griselda Hewitt-Pender. I got to know her when I arrived on this island over 12 years ago, 13 years, and I have very fond memories of Sister Pender. She said she adopted me as a son and as a mother. I knew in my heart that she was there for me. Most of the time when we met, we talked about the Bible, talked about her experiences at Bethel. And they were always uplifting. And I must confess, I at that time wondered why I wasn't privileged to have her actively in the congregation while I was pastoring, because listening to her, I realized how much I missed, how much she had to contribute, and I know was contributing to Community Baptist Church and other places where she was given the opportunity to serve, because service was her serving God and serving God's people. Was her passion. We believe that she is in a better place. We believe that that place that Jesus has gone to prepare, he has come to take Sister Pender back with him. And we pray that the family will carry on the legacy, that legacy of service. May God bless you always.
Amen.
Now invite, is it, to do the eulogy, and Jessica.
Philgence, the seventh child of Griselda Hewitt-Pender. First of all, I'd like to make a little time to give a few acknowledgments. I would like to thank God for walking with me and guiding me through this difficult time. The acknowledgment I would like to give to is James Memorial Funeral Home for the excellent service and special attention to detail. Herbert Gregholm for the age. All of mother's care givers for the last 2 years until her passing. The turning point. Cindy's the person who runs that place. And she provided periodic daycare and respite. Continuing care, a special thanks to Junie. The government of the Virgin Islands, the PERV department. It really takes a village. Thank you for all your support, kind words, and prayers. Mrs. Griselda Pender, blessed to see her 88th birthday, peacefully passed away at Herbert Greg home for the age on November 27, 2020. She was born on the island of St. Croix to Seabert and Alwina Hewitt, October 17, 1932. Griselda, also known as Zelda, was the 11th of 13 children that resided in Estate Rattan. As a child, she spent her days running, horseback riding, farming, swimming, and fishing with her brothers and sisters. At an early age, she knew she loved literature and started writing short stories. On June of 1957, at the age of 25, Griselda and two of her youngest children left the Virgin Islands and relocated to New York in pursuit of employment opportunities and education. She stayed with relatives in Brooklyn while seeking employment. Griselda quickly realized that she did not have enough experience or education. She taught herself, with the help of a sister, how to make beds as done in the hospitals and take temperatures. She was hired as a nurse's aide at the Riverside Nursing Home and also worked at Village Nursing Home, Long Island, New York. While working to support her children, she enrolled at Abby's Business Institute in Brooklyn, New York, and graduated. She was later hired as an executive secretary for the Colonial Community Association in Brooklyn, New York. She completed her education at Wadley Evening High School, where she graduated valedictorian of her class. All the while, she continued to write, adding poems to her growing collection of literature. Griselda married Alonzi Pender in 1963 and returned to St. Croix in 1975 with the three youngest of her nine beautiful children. Griselda came home with experience, trained and eager to work. A few months later, she was hired part-time as a paraprofessional at Elena Christian Junior High School. In 1997, Griselda was employed full-time with the government of the Virgin Islands at the Department of Education, working in the position of Administrative Secretary 1, Administrative Secretary 2, and Administrative Officer. She was most recognized for her work at John H. Woodson Junior High and Charles H. Emanuel Elementary School. Although all through the years, Griselda continued writing and developed her skills. Her poem, Wonderful Things, was published by Eber and Wine Publishing, for which she received awards. Griselda was a member of Bethel AME Church and later joined and served at the Community Baptist Church for many years. Griselda retired in 1997 and enjoyed the things that she loved, such as her family, traveling, dining, baking, fishing, Bible study, sewing, daily crossword puzzles, gardening, and sharing her fruits and flowers with everyone. She was an outstanding cook and was well known for her Johnny cakes. Mom was full of spirit and life, with a warm smile that made you feel good, a pillar of strength, hope, and love. Mom had fun, a fun comedic character, and all that went along with it. Sometimes she danced and made faces that would leave you in tears laughing at old-time stories and childhood antics. She was patient, kind, understanding, and forgiving. She gave us words of advice and prayers anytime, any place, and whenever it was needed. She had a way of helping each and every one of us through difficult times in our lives with her unconditional love. She never gave up when faced with obstacles and taught her children the same. While everything else may have changed, her love for all her children remained. Mom, you have not given up. You simply finished the course that God has set before you. For you have fought a good fight and kept the faith. Your legacy will live on through your children, grandchildren, great-grandchildren, and beyond. Without love to our mother, Griselda Hewitt-Pender, we love you. Rest in peace.
Your hearts for a word from the Lord. As he said, how great thou art. Let us sing to God's glory and praise.
Yeah.
gracious God, speak to me and speak through me. Help, O God, that words of my mouth, meditation of our hearts, will do some good in somebody's life this morning.
Yes.
We lift those who are fallen. Make rough ways smooth. Give joy where there is sadness. God, we pray you will do something through this message this morning.
Yes.
Someone who needs to hear this word. In Jesus' name I pray.
Yes.
I offer a single verse to reflect on this morning. Revelation chapter 14 and the 13th verse. Blessed are the dead who die in the Lord from now on, says the Spirit. They will rest from their labors, for their deeds will follow them.
Amen.
We need to understand the context of these words. John was on the Isle of Patmos, having been exiled. They were trying to destroy the church. And the church was going through a difficult time, time of persecution.
Yes.
So there was a struggle between good and evil.
Yes.
And John is trying to bring them a message that God is going to make everything turn out all right. That is what Revelation is about. In the midst of our struggles, there are words of encouragement that things will turn out fine. This too shall pass. But we're not just to focus on the context. We need to pay attention to who said. He says, I heard a voice from your heaven.
Yes, sir.
That's how it is. The verse begins, I heard a voice from heaven. Mm-hmm. And what follows is not just any old statement. This word is from heaven.
Yes.
If that doesn't make us shout, nothing else would. Especially those of us who are Christians. It is not only important for the person who said it, but what it said. It talks about the very things that are on our minds today. Moments like this make us think about life and death and future and loved ones and our own. We ponder whether life is really worth all the struggles mm-hmm. and hardships that can come our way. This verse is God's word about all that.
Yeah.
I think that's important. Listen to what it says. Blessed are the dead. That is contrary to everything that we think about life. That is not a time when we think of happy. The word blessed is translated happy. So if we were to be faithful to the translation, what John is telling us is happy are the dead.
Amen.
That's the sense of the word. How can that be? We associate that with dying and sickness and suffering and heartache and tears. We associate happiness with wealth and health and fame and big car and big house and all of that stuff going for us.
I know.
So it seemed to be contradiction there. Who is happy? I'm all dead. No. The dead is associated with funerals and hospitals and cemetery and all of that stuff. Mm-hmm. What's there to be happy about that? The Bible makes the same association. The one place where the Bible says Jesus wept was a graveside. Those of us who are in the Word know that that's the only time in the Bible where we find that Jesus wept. So how can a funeral or how can death be happy? The Bible calls death an enemy. But the ever says, heaven tells us, not Pastor Hendricks, not Pastor Williams. Heaven tells us, not Joel Osteen or TDJ. Heaven tells us, is a word directly from heaven. Blessed, happy are the dead.
Amen.
How can that be? But it didn't end there. Mm-hmm. It didn't say just blessed are the dead. It said, blessed are the dead who die in the Lord.
Amen.
This is not unqualified happiness that he's talking about. That is that every dead is going to be happy. Death is not blessed for everyone. Now is not the place to go into it, but preceding this verse is a powerful description of the happy future facing those who had no room for the Lord in this life.
My God.
But the whole verse looks at our other alternative. It insists that a person's relationship with the Lord makes a difference.
Amen.
If your death is going to be happy, it is tied to our relationship with the Lord.
Amen.
Not every death is happy, but Pender's death is happy.
My Lord.
I want to take some hermeneutical liberties this morning, and I'm going to be brief. I want to interchange or insert the word joyful. You see, happiness is tied to your circumstance. Happy because you got a promotion. Mm-hmm. Right? You're happy because your child did well in school. You're happy because you were able to pay off your mortgage. You're happy because a child in your family is getting married.
Go ahead. That's all right.
But I heard a preacher this week. In fact, one of the pastors of the bishops of the Amy Church preached Sunday. And he said, happy people are not good people to be around.
Yeah.
He said Sunday, preaching from St. Philip Amy Church in Georgia, Bishop Jackson said, the worst kind of people to be around are happy people.
Mm-hmm.
He says, whoa, a day they get up in the morning and they sleep on the wrong side of the bed. Not happy to be around that. Not nice to be around them. They get up some terrible news about some situation and they're going to take it out on you. Not the nice people to be around. He said, happy people are the worst people to be around. I want to suggest to you, the best people to be around are joyful people.
Amen.
Joy is not tied to any circumstance. Oh, what peace like a river. Attendant my will and sorrow like Stephen's rule.
Amen.
Whatever my lot thou hast taught me to say, in the midst of the struggles, in the midst of the hardship, in the midst of the difficulty, you can still smile.
Amen.
because you have joy.
Amen.
I suggest to you from my experience with Sister Zelda, she was a joyful person.
Amen.
That's my memory of her. Doesn't matter what she was going through, every time I visited with her, there was this smile, and I believe that she was using the trick to get me. Because she was going to call me and tell me, Pastor Hendricks, I have some fruits, you got to come and get them. And then sometimes I went to get the fruits, and we end up spending 3 hours, 2 hours, just talking and talking, sharing with me her poetry, sharing with me her experience in the church, telling me about the wonderful concerts that she had at Bethel, and how she liked to sing. It was a wonderful experience. It was a positive experience to be around her.
All right.
She was joyful.
Yeah,
and she was kind.
Yeah.
You see, when the Lord, when we have a relationship with the Lord, it makes a difference in our lives.
Oh, yeah.
Hallelujah. The Lord presence in a person's life makes a difference. And that person does not change with the circumstance. And the person remains the same way because his presence of the Lord was with that person. Oh, in good and in bad. And that's why David said, yea, though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I shall fear no evil.
Hallelujah.
For thou art with me.
Yeah.
Thy rod and thy staff.
Yes.
Comfort me.
Amen. Thank you, Lord.
The child or the person in the Lord is not afraid of death.
Yes.
Oh, death. Where is thy sting? Oh, grave. Where is thy victory?
All right.
This is just a pen that lived their life knowing that soon and very soon,
oh yeah,
she was going to see her king.
Oh yeah.
She was not going to allow anyone to stop her.
No, no.
From seeing her king. And while she was privileged to be in this life, she understood what being a Christian,
amen,
is all about.
Yes, Lord.
It's about reaching out to others.
Yes.
It's about helping others to come into a relationship with Christ.
Amen.
And even though I did not hear her sing this one, I knew that was something that she would have sung. If I could help somebody as I travel along,
yes,
if I should tell somebody that he's going wrong,
all right,
if I should show somebody as I travel along, help somebody, yes, then my living. Then my living.
All right.
Then my living.
Yes, sir.
Will not be in vain.
Amen.
Sister Zelda lived a joyful life.
Yes, yes.
Joyful. Joyful life. And joyful is the dead. Who die,
yeah,
in the Lord.
Yes.
Those who die in the Lord are blessed. This, yeah, text tells us. Because of what will not be.
Mm-hmm.
The next to the last chapter of the Bible speaks of the same blessings. Now the dwelling of God is with men.
Yes.
And he will live with them. Hallelujah.
Yeah.
There will be his people. God himself will be with them and be their God. And he will wipe away every tear from their eyes.
Oh yeah.
There will be no more death or mourning or crying.
Hallelujah.
Or pain. Zelda, Sister Zelda, is in no more pain. For all things has passed away.
Yes, sir.
Oh, yes, my brothers and sisters. There's another text that tells us that their deeds will follow them.
Amen.
Also, although our deeds follow, I think there are two ways. Both are very real in this text. The Bible tells us that there will be a reunion with God.
Amen.
And it says that we shall rest
yes.
from our labor. We shall rest.
Yes.
Hallelujah. The greatest reward will be the simple words of the Lord. Well done. Well done.
Yes.
The good and faithful servant.
Yes.
Blessed are those who die in the Lord, for their deeds will follow them. Their deeds, our deeds.
Yes.
And I trust that the family of Sister Zelda will carry on those deeds. Legacies will continue through her children, grandchildren, great-grandchildren, grandchildren, family, sisters, everybody. We'll look back at her life and realize that she was a positive influence.
Yes.
And you want to continue. Amen.
Yeah.
Family hymn. Blessed be the tide that binds. Love for this family will continue. together, Lord. The cords that cannot be broken.
Yes.
Help to keep them in your care.
Yes.
And may they, Lord, take from Zelda and carry on that passion for service.
Yes.
Her kindness. Her warm person. May they continue the legacy of caring for each other.
Yes.
And loving each other. Strengthen them, we pray now.
Yes.
And give them the strength to go on.
Yes.
In spite of the departure of Zelda. Give them the strength to go on. In Jesus' name I pray. Thank you.